Okay, here's something interesting. React Router is one of the most used libraries out there because pretty much all React projects, all serious React projects, use React Router, I'd argue, unless they maybe use Next.js and are built with something like that. But all these single-page applications, they most likely use React Router. Now, why is that interesting? Because the React Router team, in the end, the developers of React Router, are also the developers of Remix. And Remix is a React framework, a full-stack framework like Next.js, and it was created a couple of years ago already. Now, Remix is definitely less popular than Next.js. Also because Next.js is much older, it's been around longer, but maybe also due to marketing and who knows what. So, that's that. The interesting thing now is that at ReactConf 2024, so not long ago, the React Router team and therefore the Remix team announced that they would kind of stop working on Remix and instead they would turn React Router into their full-stack React framework. To summarize what they said, that's essentially it because they saw that what they're building with Remix now is essentially React Router, or that Remix is mostly now using React Router features internally. And that's why they decided to switch to React Router and essentially make sure that you can use React Router like you use Remix today, without breaking your project. So if you are using React Router already, you can continue using it and it won't suddenly turn into some full stack project or anything like that. You can use it as you are used to. But with the next major version of React Router, version 7, they will, or they plan to finish this migration, if you want to call it like this. So React Router will then become Remix, if you want to call it like this, though it will stay React Router. The name will stay React Router, but it will have all these Remix features, you could say. And therefore, every project in the world that uses React Router could then, in theory, if they wanted to, switch their app to a full stack React app. They could opt into that new mode without changing much about their code and project, maybe without changing anything. And that's super interesting because this move could really make React Router and therefore in the end Remix the number one React framework, which currently is Next.js. But since all these projects are using React Router and presumably switching to that full stack app will be super simple once you update it to React Router 7, there might not be too many reasons to use Next.js instead. Now, don't get me wrong, there might be reasons. Next.js is more than just a file system router. They do offer lots of built-in features which people like. There are many reasons to use Next.js. But having an easy time switching your app from a normal single-page app to such a full-stack app, that's also a pretty good reason. And that's therefore a super smart move by the React Router team, even though it probably wasn't planned as such. They did not start working on Remix to then come back to React Router 4 years later and decide, hey, that's our framework. But that's what we'll end up with now anyways. And I'm super excited about this because you don't have to use this. You don't have to turn your app into such a framework powered app. You don't have to build a full stack app. You can still use React Router as you always did. But having this option and having this easy, smooth upgrade path, presumably at least, that's pretty interesting. What do you think about that?